We started working on this model in part one, and in part two, we will continue and learn how to work with bodies in Shapr3D.
So we're going to create another new sketch here, but I want to create a custom plane to put it on. So I'm going to use the add tool and make a construction plane, use the flyout to get a different type, and I'll get through 3 points. I'll select on this corner. Even though this corner doesn't highlight, when you pick, it goes straight to that corner. And there's our new plane. Click done. New sketch on this new plane. We're squared up to it. Create an arc. Goes across and up to here. And then some new lines to enclose that. I really only need to go so far with this. I'll show you why here in a moment. Now I want to get the center of the arc lined up on the center plane. Notice that the sketch is stuck in the middle of the part, and we want it all on one side so we can cut through in one action. So I'm going to select the sketch, make sure I exit the sketch, and then I can move this sketch up out of the part, and then I'll select inside again, and I can make this cut. Now notice that it cuts both parts. That's not what we want, but we'll accept that and go to the history tree in the extrusion, expand the extrusion and the target, deselect the second feature, and we can do that here in the graphics window, and then done. And now the first feature is the only one that's cut, and we've got this nice curve. Now we also want to angle this curve back somewhat. So let's create a reference axis. So we'll say construction axis, and then the type will be through 2 points. These 2 points will be here and here. Click done. And now we want to use transform rotate around axis and select items to rotate this face, next, and then rotate around axis, maybe this axis, and drag the arrow so we can watch this visually angle back. Let's put it about 80 degrees and done. Okay. So now we can turn off this first sketch. We don't need that again, but let's take a look at this. Open another sketch on this plane and do the same sort of sketch. We'll make the arc radius much smaller and draw in some lines that are big enough to include the second revolve feature. And these don't have to be nice and neat. Again, this sketch is not where we want it to be, so let's exit the sketch. And move it above the part. And then we can select inside the shaded area and make the cut that goes all the way through.
This concludes part 2. In part 3, we will finish this model.